Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Quirky Crafty Me. Today I wanted to share an ATC set that I had created for my mother. My mother had printed out a really big stack of butterflies for me, thank you mom, and she had said that she liked the red butterflies a lot, so I decided to do this set for her. Now I'm just prepping the watercolor papers with water so that the paints flow properly. It's just a basic watercolor set, a cheap one I picked up from one of our Chinese stores. I did have a problem with these paints. They did not want to gel properly with the paper. When I had done my swatches, it had been fine, but I had done the swatches on the cheaper paper with the cheap paint. And the paper I'm using for the ATCs are a more expensive watercolor paper. So I don't know if it's the cheap paint, quality paper concept that was giving me issues there. At this point I thought I'd zoom in a bit closer so you can see the flow of the paints. Going over the cards with the colors to see if I couldn't get a better color depth. They faded out completely or they became really, really grainy. So I just kept on faffing on them, hoping that I can get a better color. Now I'm going to be adding a swirl stamp to the cards. I have no idea what the stamp set is called. I had thrown away the packaging way back when. I do remember it's from Chiswick. And I'm using, I think it's Dewdrop Pearlescent Brown ink. And I do want to apologize for the wiggliness of the video. I was working on my TV tray. It's a plastic tray. That's why I'm also having a problem with the stamping. It tends to not want to stamp the middle because it's plastic. It pushes a dent underneath. Luckily, I had a book at hand. I had the cutouts done previously. Now at this stage I had not planned any further than the card with the stamps on it. So I'm just sizing the butterflies. and you know, just going through the process of trying to decide what I'm going to do with them. And I had the quote from another printout. Now I'm trying to decide if I'm going to, you know, dirty up the print out a bit, because it's very stark white against the brownish quartz. I ended up not doing it because the brown ink is quite dark. Just zoomed in a bit to show you the process of placing the butterflies. Faffing around with it quite a bit, I could not decide where what goes. And there I get my light bulb moment. Just adding some double-sided tape to stick the two layers of butterflies to each other. And as usual, struggling with the double-sided tape. It's my arch nemesis, I'm pretty sure of it. Forgotten to excuse me, to turn on the camera for the first bit there. I just stuck down the butterfly and then the spread. Unfortunately, there I faffed around so much with the yaw that I actually ripped the R. Luckily, with gel medium, there's quite a bit of playing room. Now just going to do a little bit of doodling detailing on the butterflies itself. Here I'm using a dark silver, I would say a gunmetallish grey, These are just basic gel pens. They don't have a brand. I just got them from a grocery store. I do wish I had zoomed in a bit more on this phase, just to show the detail I was adding to the butterflies. White gel pen on the swirls of the stamp to just bring it out a bit more, and to tie in the white of the quote. I initially thought of coloring the quote with the brown watercolors, that's why I had the fine brush on the table with me, but then decided against it, and then thought that, you know, the white dots will tie it in properly. Thank you. was edging them here with what I thought was the brown ink pad. At a stage you'll see me looking at the ink pad and I realized that it's not brown, it's black. But it's on the third card, so it's a bit too late to realize it then. Right there. I had decided that there's a few blank spots on the card, so I thought I'd fill it with another swirl so they don't look so blank. There we go, all done. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like and subscribe. Share it to your friends if you think they would enjoy it. I hope you have an awesome week.